Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. I hope you're all well, and welcome back to round 8 of my GT3 Championships. It's been a while since we've done one of these. This one's a little bit different. We're going to do a 10 lapper here today with multipliers for time, fuel, and tyre usage. So that should force a pit stop anywhere between laps 4 and 7. 20 cars on the grid, 4 mix of manufacturers, and we are starting 9th. So let's get this underway. See how we go. Hopefully we can get through the source without a scratch. Oops, squeeze through. Car right next to me. Oh, wow, that was pretty bad. Lift off a little bit there. Oh, tap me. So the cars are set to 115 skill and 40 aggression, so probably explains that little bump. This is about my 10th attempt at actually recording this kind of mini enduro, to the point where I've even swapped circuits, versions of Spa. This is the race rFactor version, so it's probably a little bit older than the one I was running before, but AI seem to prefer, or sorry, behave a little bit better here. And this one's a little bit more varied. There's more track variation, undulations and bumps, whereas the other one was basically just smooth. The ripple strips here are a little less forgiving as well, as you just saw. So I just think it's a better racing experience. Although that's blinding. I don't know if that's a DirectX 11 compatibility issue or if it's just the time of day. The race has started at 4 p.m. and I've got a 10 time multiplier for time, so it could just be the sun. I guess we'll see as it gets darker whether that thing hangs around. Oh, been overtaken. Let's see if we can get that back at the source. Trying to get the inside line if he doesn't. Oh! Well, he's insane. Although that worked. I think he's still right next to me though. Oh! Four wheel drift through there. We head down Kemmel. Let's see if we can catch that McLaren. I'm just going to keep an eye on the laps this time, so I can at least, because I'll forget where I'm running before I need to pit. I think we're going to try and pit early. I think I'm going to try and pit as soon as I finish my fourth lap, or just before I start my fifth. Just got to get there first, I guess. Overcook that big time. Through Stavlo there, that was pretty bad that time. Miss shift. And blind again. Try and keep that distance between us and that Merc. Let's see, here we go. He's right there, I can hear him. That looks like the lead car. Oof. It's very slippy through there. This version anyway. Yep. Out on the brakes into Bruxelles. Track seems to be rubbering up a little bit now, not quite so slippy through there. Just come up to Pouhon. But it is slippery through here still. Quarters sideways through that time. Oof. Wow. Through Blanchimont. So we come up to bus stop, which isn't really bus stop anymore because it's just a chicane. And I'll whinge about that every time we come past it. Broke way too early then.
That was a 224.30.
So I think we'll get this lap down. Then we'll pit the lap after. Before we start the fifth. Wow. It's quite a way ahead. Don't know what he is. It might be a radical. Come through campus. Ooh. Gotta watch that AstroTurf there. Actually, no, if I'm gaining on this guy. 6 seconds, wow. Going a little bit through there, but not much.
24.68.
Got a much better entry. Wow. He's flying through right along a rouge, isn't he? I think we'll pit this one. Let's just select our pit. Okay, we'll just go with fuel. Because I feel the tires are going to be okay. Massively overshot that. Get it together. So we come through Stavlo. Okay. Yeah, tires will be fine.
That was a 252.47.
Okay, probably don't need to watch that anymore. Let's see where we are. Starting to get a little bit darker as well. Racing line starting to build up a little bit as well. A little bit more grip. Okay, let's turn the headlights on. Yep, so it looks like it might have actually just been the sun glare. So there's a few cars in the pits, let's see if we can get past them.
That was a 234.32.
Up to 17th. Oh. Really is no kind of apex Subaru Excel there. It's such a long, curve, pause. Truly overshot that. Through Stablo again. Blanche some more. Lift a little bit here. So we might pass somebody else.
The lap was a 225.63.
Up into 16th. I would think that the majority of them would have to pit this lap if they haven't already and not just fallen so far behind. A little bit of shake in the wheel now. I think we've got a tiny flat spot. Wow, 17th is gaining on me big time. Come on.
Wow, he's flying.
What is going on there? lap was a 2:25. Tires are starting to go off. Couple of laps left to go. Starting to get very dark now. I'm starting to stuff up. It was almost like someone else's headlights behind me illuminating the road. It's been a very quiet second half of the race, hasn't it? I think I completely misjudged the pits on that one, and we've gone from one lap to go, gone from ninth to all the way down to 16th, and I thought I had some good race pace too. Right, concentrate this last lap, keep that guy off me. So we head down Kemmel for the last time. Into Lake Coombe. Hear him, he's right on me. I think I've let myself down with my tyres. It sounds and looks kind of like a Corvette with the lights. Keep him at bay. No. Is it, or is it a Bentley? Ooh, I think I've just kept him at bay there. Wow. Well, that's over. I hope you enjoyed that, guys. If you did, please leave a like, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and I'll be sure to upload more content soon. Thanks, everyone. Bye.